everybody. This is a Chef to Chef Live brought to you by Club and Resort Chef Association. And this week's sponsor is Chef's Works. So we appreciate Chef Works for sponsoring the club chefs around the country. And today we're with a couple of South Florida chefs. First of all, we have Christopher Park from Wycliffe Country Club and Carlos Addarich from Tampa Bay Yacht Club. Guys, what is it, about 95, 100 degrees down there right about now?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, that's about right.
Yeah. Thanks for joining me today. I'd like to ask, and Chef Carlos, we can start with you about where your operation is right now as far as your capacity and what you're normally doing. What are you doing now? And is the volume up? Is it down? Is it stagnant? And maybe just touch base about that with me real quick.
Well, we're running at 50%. Most of the business that we're having, believe it or not, is out at the pavilion kitchen, which is the pool area and the marina area. Even though we're doing 50% out there because of the outside seating, there's way much room to spread people out. So that's where we're seeing most of the business. Typically, we will be way much busier for dinner inside the club, but because of the mandates, we are way much, obviously, running way much lower volume than usual. We're still doing a lot of meals to go or curbside service. So we're still fairly busy for this time of the year, and of course, you know, with everything that's going on.
Would this typically for both of you, would this typically be considered an off season though for you being in South Florida? Or?
Yes, sir, absolutely. But no one is traveling outside the state. So yeah. For that reason, it's been busier than usual. We usually close the club for 2 weeks from the second week of July to the first week of August. We've been closing the club for the past 25 years for 2 weeks just to deep clean and repaint and retouch and so forth and so on. But because of the recent events, it's the first time in years that we're still open through the summer.
Cool. Chef Chris, what do you think, man?
Our volume has actually been pretty good. It's pretty much what we've been running on a normal summer basis, except we don't have all the big events. So our a la carte's actually been holding up pretty strong. We do have our main restaurant, our grill room restaurant, that we run 3 nights a week for a la carte, which have been quite busy. Most of the seating has been outside. I'd say probably about 75% of the seating are outside seating. But it's been doing really good. We actually opened our fine dining restaurant 1 day every other week, and that's actually been a good turnout too, but we're able to sit inside and outside. So we've been getting a good response on that. But it's actually, we're holding on to our business. We're not losing much, except for all the big events and things like that. A la carte wise, we're holding on. We're about where we're at, usually at this time of year.
It seems like that's a common theme with most of the club chefs right now. Their a la carte is doing really good. Obviously, we're all suffering with events and outside, catering and things like that. Carlos, you said you are at 50%. Chris, you're at 75. So are we dealing with just county measures, not necessarily state measures when it comes to the seating?
Yeah, absolutely. County measures is It's just a decision that we took here in the club, especially inside. And the members have responded really well. No one have showed any discontent because of the extra measurements that we're taking. So yeah, it's just basically extra measurement on our part just to make sure that we keep proper distance in between everyone.
Is that the same with you, Chris? It's a club mandated decision for 75%?
Well, we're at 50%, we only let about 50% of our occupancy, but out of 50%, 25% of the people that come are eating outside.
Okay, 75%. Gotcha.
Yeah. Only 25% of the reservations are eating inside and 75% are eating outside. But we're only at the same as everyone else at the 50% occupancy for here. But like some majority all want to eat outside, which, yeah. For this time of year, it's hot outside, but they still want to come and they want to eat outside.
Yeah, so. Get used to it.
Yeah.
Talk to me about your menu selections. Is your menu more limited now? Is there less staff in the kitchen? Obviously, we're not doing the banquets, as we said, but are your choices more limited? And I've talked to Chef recently where they're turning over the menu a little more frequently. What's your menu philosophy, Chris, right now, in the last couple months?
The last couple months is basically keeping things new and exciting as much as possible. So we've been actually on a 1 to 2 week menu cycle. So every week or every 2 weeks, we change the menu. We have been doing a weekly special or a daily special, but every week it's something, we send out to our members every week what the special is going to be for each day of the week. And that's been probably our biggest seller, is keeping things new and exciting on that weekly specials. Our staff-wise, I've actually been able to keep everyone right now. We've cut back a little bit of hours, but we've been doing a grocery store. We have the to-go options, and then we just started opening up in the dining room, so we're able to keep everyone on board, which has been good. To keep everyone together is always good for our yearly staff.
Did you have to furlough anyone, Chris, or put anybody on unemployment, anything during any slow time?
No, actually, fortunately, we have not. It's been really good, and morale's really been up because we've been able to do that. So we've been able to keep everyone going.
That's great. Carlos, talk to me about your menu and staffing and everything. Are you guys 100%, you feel, or?
We started a new summer menu, full-blown summer menu, the second week of June. Just because we changed the menu basically 3 times a year. We also do what we call the comfort food specials, and we do 5 comfort food specials, and we change it every other week. So we're offering as many dishes as possible as we can just to keep it exciting, because we are seeing a lot of returning members and a lot of to-go orders. We have recently done a to-go app, so the members can place the order to go. They place it right off from their phone or from their tablets. They specify at what time they're gonna pick it up, with half an hour lead time for each order. That standard, and that it's been really successful. But we launched a new summer menu probably about a month now, and the comfort food specials, same at the pool. At the pool, like I said earlier, we're way much busier than usual at this time of the year, and We are running a full menu. Of course, the pool menu is always a limited menu, only 10 items. And of course, that includes sandwiches, wraps, and so forth and so on. But we run every comfort food special there as well. That changes, 3 of them that changes every other week. So we are trying to offer as much as many different items as possible, just to ensure that the members have something different to choose from. And we've seen that they're ordering 3 or 4 times out of the to-go menu a week. Quite surprising.
So it's a, Carlos, it's a bigger menu. It just doesn't change as much. It's and Chris, you probably have obviously a smaller menu that changes quite a bit more, right?
Actually, I have a it's a pretty good menu. It's about 10 or 12 items for dinner alone, and okay. Lunchtime it's good size too. I do want to touch base on that app. We actually started the app too with a pace setter, and that actually has helped out a lot. We did a survey just the other day. About 75% of our members are using the app to place orders, which helps out a lot. Like the same thing, we can set a different time or a certain time with them when they want to pick up or delivery. We have a delivery service too. So, but the app has been helping out so much. And on our staffs, we created a call center with our staff where our servers that, you know, since we don't have money hours for our servers have been doing manning the call service and also the app off the tablets and taking orders, ringing those in. So that's actually been a great help for our members.
Do you find, Chris and Carlos, do you find that you're getting less modifiers when the members are doing their orders? Because that's obviously a server goes out there and a member wants this, this, and this, so they just write it down and send it in the kitchen. We're all familiar with that tactic. But do you find the app kind of eliminates some of those modifiers and simplifies things for you?
I do. I have seen our tickets actually got a lot smaller, so being 10 inches, now they're only, you know, the normal 4 inches or so. So absolutely, I think they take a lot of the, you know, the changes and stuff and trust us how we put the menu together and let us do our creative aspect on it.
Yeah.
Same here. You still have those members that are very particular of what they want, and they will call the orders in rather than to put it in the app, and then you will see the modifiers for those particular people that place their orders over the phone. But for the most part, if the member uses the app, they're pretty concise.
Can you guys both talk to me about your kitchen safety plans? Is everyone wearing masks? What's protocol for people coming in right now? It's a little different around the country, but Carlos, you want to touch base on that? Is there a protocol?
Everyone coming in have to be wearing a mask. Cooks, dishwashers, our vendors, they have to wear a mask. We also have established a sanitizing solution right next to our sink by the door. So we have a big sign asking everyone to come in from outside to wash their hands and sanitize after. Everyone has to wear a mask. And we also are taking temperatures. We have a thermometer, and we take temperatures of everyone randomly. And if anyone is not feeling well, they're excused to go home. Absolutely, yeah.
Chris, you pretty buttoned up with masks and everything?
Yes, everyone comes in with a mask on. You know, we've been having weekly meetings basically with our staff. And I think that's the biggest thing is communicating with them is encourage them to make sure they're washing their hands, they're wearing their mask, but they're not just doing it here, but they're doing it when they're outside of work too. You know, I spend a lot of time with my staff during season, and you know, I consider them second family pretty much, and I want to make sure that when they take things home to their family, they make sure they're not taking things home, you know, to our home too here in the kitchen. But we do pretty much the same thing: temperature checks, mask, gloves when they're required for gloves, but washing the hands is the most important too. We also have a clean company that comes and does a fogging every single night pretty much. In March we started doing it basically 5 nights a week, but now we've switched it to 7 nights a week. So they come in, they fog basically everywhere in the clubhouse, the kitchens, everywhere, from the fitness center, administration, everywhere. So that's our, you know, our basic thing is we're sticking to the guidelines and just encouraging and working with our staff, and communication with them is the biggest key.
Cool.
Yeah, same here. We have, I'm sorry, Jeff, same here. We have adopted the fogging, sanitizing plan. So we don't do it every day. We do it every other day. But every other day, the company comes and sanitizes the whole club. And like Jeff said, you know, they do all areas every other day.
There's obviously people want to talk about Florida being a bit of a hotspot right now with the resurgence of the COVID reaching up there now. What's the management's philosophy? I mean, are you just cautiously optimistic? Are you starting to put anything in place to maybe revisit in a week or two for now? You know, plans going forward, Chris?
You know, like I said, our biggest thing is communication with our members, of let them know what's going on and, you know, if there's anything that they need to worry about. But also communicating that, you know, the club is safe, what measures were taken. You know, we've tried to do a couple small events, but our members aren't ready. I mean, we tried a movie night, but it, you know, with about 40 people, socially distanced and everything, but they're still not ready for those kind of events, which, you know, is fine, understandable. But we'll keep trying to visit them, keep trying to, you know, encourage them that we're okay to do it. But they've definitely started feeling comfortable with coming in to eat, which is really nice. So our numbers that, you know, when we're open for all the carts for dine-in or outside seating, they come, and it's great to see them. And also they've been, you know, supporting the golf course and the tennis. They're feeling comfortable with the measures they're doing for that. So, I mean, just communication with them. And, you know, each day we look at what we can do. And, you know, if we try it. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But, you know, we just keep trying.
Yeah, I think that's a philosophy everybody's going through. Everybody's going through it for the first time. And there's comfort in clubs. I think that's why a la carte is up and a lot of the to-gos and everything are up. It's the comfort level that people have with the club. And that's just a silver lining that we might overlook in something like this, why members, you know, I do appreciate everybody being open and doing what they can. So, Carlos, you're obviously at a yacht club on the water, everything like that. Is everybody kind of cautiously optimistic you can keep running with what you're doing right now for the near future?
Yes, absolutely. We are doing the best we can. Same here. When it comes to events, we are not doing events. You know, we do our member meetings up to 20 some people. That's it. But no major events. We're talking about fall. Fall is a big time of the year for us for the wedding season. And we are starting to talk about that aspect because we have some weddings in the books. We don't know yet if we're going to be able to proceed or not, but we haven't made that decision yet. Quite frankly, I don't know if we're gonna proceed or not. It's gonna be certainly a collective decision among the senior leaders of the club, and of course with the board of governors. But we are not there yet. But let's see. For the meantime, we're just taking care of our members, the one that comes every week, the ones that like to socialize, and the ones that want to come and spend time in their boats or playing tennis or at the equestrian center. About events, we don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah. We touched base on the menus, limited menus and everything. I want to get into just a little quick personal feeling about your menus? You're obviously both in South Florida. I'm sure there's a lot of seafood going around. When you're developing a menu, Chef Chris, is that first and foremost on your mind? And has that sourcing been pretty consistent throughout this pandemic for the last 5 months as far as getting what you need for you know, a successful menu from your standpoint?
Yeah, pretty much our menu, we do have a lot of seafood on it. You know, we're being in South Florida, we're surrounded by water. So we do have a lot of seafood on our menu. We've been fortunate enough that a lot of things actually have still been available. So we haven't had to, you know, adjust that way. You know, especially with seafood. I mean, the fishermen are actually hurting right now. So prices are actually a little bit down. I mean, we've ran actually a few lobster nights too that have been really fortunate for us too. But seafood is definitely a thing. But other purveyors, we haven't really had much issue with food not being available. That's out there. It's the issues we have, you know, is the gloves, the sanitizer, those kind of things are hard to find. But food-wise, it's not too much. You know, we do have to just check our quality when it comes in and make sure they're up to par. But really no issues with being able to order things food-wise.
Is there something that the members always want to see? And I'll get back to that in a minute as far as specific things. But are they expecting a 80% seafood menu from you? Or is that your philosophy?
No, we're not like an 80% seafood. I mean, I try to run a nice mix with a nice assortment of a little bit of everything. I mean, when we do a menu, I want to make sure I have, you know, my shellfish. I want to make sure I have a couple different fish available. But I want a couple different steaks on there. I want something, you know, pork related. So it's a well blended mix of everything on our menu. So it's not all dominated seafood, but it has a little bit more mixture of seafood than you know, I guess anywhere else.
Chef Carlos, you just redid your menu, and what went through your head as far as variety and what the members want?
Yeah, well, you know, like Chef Chris said, we have a good mix too. We do a lot of seafood, but it's not seafood forward. The menu is well balanced. But it's summertime, so we try to keep it simple, light, fresh in the sense that we use a lot of fruits and so forth and so on. At the beginning of when everything started, it was really hard for us to get get high quality ingredients just because of what happened and transportation issues. We had a lot of transportation issues from our vendors, but now things have stabilized a little bit. Quality though, we have to be really careful. When it comes to seafood, we're fortunate that we have two good vendors that are very loyal to us. So the quality of seafood's been there. But when it comes to produce and so forth and so on, we have to pay close attention to the quality because the production, I don't think the demand is as high as the production, obviously. That's why the low prices and that's why you have to be really careful when you receive. We're managing well. We're managing well. And you know, like Chef Chris said, we have some different type of fish and we have shellfish, we have some mollusk and so forth, just to balance the seafood offerings.
So Carlos, I like to ask all the chefs, what's on your menu? How long have you been at the Yacht Club, Carlos?
I've been here 2 years now.
2 years. So you might have inherited a dish or something. What's on the menu that you didn't take off? What's on the menu that if you took off something, they would have said, please redo this menu and put this back on?
Well, you know, it's very interesting because, you know, you have simple dishes as fried chicken. You know, we sell fried chicken anyway, fried chicken, and and you cannot take the fried chicken off the menu, and that's okay. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. It's really good fried chicken. But also when it comes to seafood, we have a macadamia across the black grouper that we cannot take out of the menu because people love that dish. And so forth and so on. But, you know, we try to do, we try to be adventure with the comfort food specials because of the different age groups, we can play it around with the comfort food specials and then try to appeal to all of them easily. And that works out well for us. But you know, basically, we always have a vegan / vegetarian friendly option on the menu. We have 4 or 5 composed salads that the member can add a piece of grilled chicken or fish and make it an entree. We, of course, the burger, we have a Cuban sandwich that everybody loves, and we cannot take out of the menu.
Leave that on, so
yeah, so that's that. We, you know, my philosophy is, you know, fresh ingredients, cook in a simple way, and I stand by that. We limit the components of a plate to 4, and that includes, you know, your starch, your vegetable, your sauce, and your protein, and of course a garnish, usually micros and a little bit of oil. But we try to keep it simple, and you know, we've been successful with that, you know, with that philosophy for the past 2 years.
Don't screw it up. Don't screw up the food, right? I mean, it's good the way it is. Hey, Chris, what's on your menu that you either inherited or can't take off?
I've actually been pretty fortunate that I don't have much that I can't change, except for there's the one thing, and that's the chicken soup. I cannot touch really? The chicken soup. It's been the recipe for 30 years. When I just got here, they said, don't touch it. So I haven't touched it.
I thought for sure you're going to say crab cakes or something.
No, it's the chicken soup. That's what it is. But they love their chicken soup. They love how it's done. It's a good soup recipe, so I'm not going to mess with it. But they let me get creative with anything else, and they're happy with the changes and then the different variety. And like I said, we've been changing the menu as much as possible, so it's constantly something new for them. So they keep coming back, which I think is a great thing.
So, has the same person been making that soup for years now?
In the kitchen? Actually, I have a gentleman here for 27 years, so he's pretty close to being the first one to come up with it. So I don't mess with it.
Yeah, absolutely not.
Yeah.
Chefs, thanks for your time today. We're right at our mark here, but good luck down south there. Hope you stay cool, and hope you stay open and still able to serve your members as you've been doing. So be safe, okay?
Thank you for having us.
Yep. Thank you. Take care.